The naming of this long and interesting pass causes plenty of confusion. On the government maps it's labelled as Seesterswoeg. This name has been inadvertently altered by several good map sources to read Seesterswoeg with an F. To add to this confusion, it's known locally, amongst others, as Marmanskloof Pass, the Spoegrivier Pass and the Karkams Pass. In Namaqualand, the manner of word construction is somewhat different to the rest of South Africa, and the naming of any word ending in heights is called a hoog, as opposed to the more grammatically correct hoogte. Thus, many names in this region end with the word hoog, which is the correct official spelling. The pass is long at 16.2 kilometers and contains 38 bends, corners and curves, some of which are very sharp and have negative banking. The road follows a very different vertical profile to the usual classic pass shape and ends in a steep descent down into the Spoegrivier Valley. It connects Karkams in the east with Spoegrivier in the west and provides an alternative and much slower route to Hondeklip Bay. The road initially heads west along a fairly level section of mountain plateau, skirting many small peaks between 750 and 800 meters in height. The road descends very gently at a gradient of 1 in 13 until the 1.8 kilometer mark, where a sharp 80 degree right-hand bend is reached. Once through this right-hand bend, the direction changes directly into the north and steepens to a gradient of 1 in 10 for the next 400 meters. Next up is a very sharp 100 degree left-hand bend, which contains some negative banking. Don't be deceived by a road that appears to carry straight on at the apex of this bend, as it's on private land. With the heading now back into the west, the farm named Langdam is traversed. Watch out for pedestrians as well as farm animals on the road. Before driving this pass, be aware that this road does not receive a lot of maintenance and is generally in a state of disrepair with some very serious corrugations. Once your vehicle starts bouncing on corrugations, you will lose traction, and with that loss of traction, you'll probably also lose control of your vehicle. This often results in a rollover with fatalities. The road climbs gently for the next 1.8 kilometers, where another 90 degree right-hand bend is reached. The gravel road intersects from the left at this bend, which is a very long road from Klipfontein and includes the very interesting and historical Bethel's Klip. The road now begins descending as it follows a long ridge along the eastern side of Marmanskloof. This kloof forms a substantial ravine with radiating arms, and the road builders decided it was easier and more economical to skirt the ravine along the spine of the ridges rather than descend and ascend this kloof along a shorter routing. This loop into the north is what makes this pass so enjoyable to drive, as it provides wonderful high vistas over Marmanskloof from several vantage points as the road maintains its altitude. The road undulates significantly until the 7.1 kilometer mark, with very little overall change in altitude. The views to the left are wonderful, and the road can be seen for a long way ahead as it follows the spine of the main ridge. One of the best ways to reduce the effects of corrugations is to reduce tire pressures. Start with 1.4 bar all round and reduce that level until the vehicle feels right. If you're not in a four-wheel drive vehicle, please don't drive fast on corrugations. At the 7.1 kilometer mark, there's an 80 degree left-hand bend, but it's not really sharp. This is a great spot to stop and admire the landscape, which offers 200 degree views. This is a perfect spot to take a break from the incessant corrugations. Continue for another 700 meters into the west-southwest, where two easier left-hand bends follow each other at the 8-kilometer point. The coastal port of Hondeklip Bay got its name from a famous rock that once looked like a dog. Of course, there's the wreck of the Aristea, which was a fishing trawler that ran aground in 1945, apparently due to an inebriated skipper. The village is a must-visit Namaqualand destination. Here the road starts heading into the south as it follows the western rim of Marmanskloof. At the 8.7 kilometer mark, there's a tight right-hand bend which leads into a short steep descent and levels off in a dip at the 9.7 kilometer point. Be sure to watch part 2 of the Seesterswoeg Pass, which deals with the more dramatic and very steep section into the Spoegrivier Valley.